Hey, let's get into what happened in State Property, man. Let's get it. I actually watched State Property. This movie was actually funny.
It starts off with some narration. You know damn well it starts off with some narration. How else would it start? How else do you start your crime action hood movie? It's a crime action hood movie, by the way.
My name is, well, forget about my real name. Everybody out there call me Beans. I know we don't look like much right now, but you'll see.
Beanie Siegel's the main character. He's like a bum or whatever. He's like a low-level hustler. He don't be getting no money. He look crazy and dirty. His facial hair look crazy and terrible. Also, his shape up, too. I could go all day, really. He not getting no money, though. That's why he look all crazy. Let's give him a break. It's fine. He at the strip club with his homeboy. In the middle of the day. Well, there's your problem right there, Beanie Siegel. You shouldn't be broke at the strip club. Everything is so overpriced. It's not worth it at all. Also, strippers don't like that.
He's sitting up in this fucking bar in the middle of the day doing what? Nothing. I need that big ass fucking crib, man. My moms and my girls decked out living lovely. Yo, pretty soon, man, you're gonna be able to do what the fuck you want.
He randomly gets inspired out of nowhere to start being a better drug dealer. He tells his homeboy all about his vague plan to get to the top of the dope game. This nigga here name is Baby Boy. They best friends or something. He's another Philly rapper also, by the way, in real life. Just like Benny Siegel. They both rappers. That's why they're acting so bad.
Nah, hey, this movie a real life classic, bruh. This my movie, bruh.
That shit you was talking earlier today. What up?
Holla at me now.
What's up, bitch?
Oh my god.
Speaking of bad acting and obscure rap niggas, Memphis Bleek shows up in the movie. He comes in and randomly murders some random guy with no setup at all. It's pretty gangster.
Yo, I'm telling you, man, we need a motherfucking killer like that on our squad for real.
There go that nigga right there.
Yo, Blizz!
Here you go.
Yo, Blizz, man. Yo, fuck it's me, nigga. Put
Beanie Siegel's impressed by the way Memphis Bleek shoots random people for no reason. He wants them to join their team or something. Also, this nigga that got killed at the strip club, was this nigga by himself? At the strip club? That's so convenient, right? You would think he'd have some homeboys with him or something.
You need your homeboys.
But yeah, they got a little team together now, and they roll up on some old nigga. He liked the big drug dealer in the area. Beanie Siegel tells him that he's taking over the whole hood. You gotta get down or lay down. That's his catchphrase or something. He say it a lot. I like it.
Come on, man. Put this little crazy motherfucker, man. Listen, bitch, you don't have to do this. There's enough in this for both of us, man.
That's where you fucking wrong at, you fat motherfucker. Didn't I tell you, Fletch? Didn't I? Fat fuck. Fat motherfucker.
Y'all take this nigga with y'all bare hands, bruh. This where y'all niggas be going wrong, bro. Y'all touching, y'all doing crimes and doing shit with y'all bare hands, bruh.
Beanie Siegel takes over all the old nigga territory and he rich now. He gets extra fresh or whatever, I guess. He still look pretty crazy though. I don't know if this is supposed to be a glow up. This nigga look exactly the same. Cut that shit off your chin, bro.
Damn, jeans. Your ass fat. It's like,
fat ass jeans.
Ain't nothing. I gotta go handle some business with Baby Boy later on.
You sure? I'm not trying to hear that shit tomorrow, babe.
Beanie Siegel's hanging out with his sexy ass, ratchet ass baby mom. He must be selling a lot of these drugs, bro. Good for him. Then they kill some more drug dealers after that. They taking over more territory. They selling a lot of drugs now, I guess. They don't actually show them selling the drugs at all. They only show the killing people part of it. I'm guessing the drugs thing is going good though. I don't know.
You gonna get down or you gonna fucking lay down? What is it gonna be, players? Y'all gonna get down or lay down?
Get down.
Huh?
Get down.
All right, then.
Janie Siegel got a new house and everybody having fun now and wearing Rockaware. Everybody look great in their Rockaware. Janie Siegel girlfriend not actually having fun though. She real worried about him and she want him to spend more time at home. Bitch, this nigga's a fucking murderer. What the fuck? You should be concerned about that shit first. This nigga is a legit serial killer. He not even fazed by that shit.
What's up, kid? You need something? What I need? Look like I fucking smoke crack.
Get down.
What I need you to do is deliver me a fucking message. Tell your man Butter that Beans came through.
They gotta defeat the next drug dealer now and take over more territory.
You already know what it is. Either get down or you gonna lay down.
Fuck y'all niggas. I see you in the street.
Put your 3D glasses on then, pussy. Cause you know we coming straight at you. Fucking basketball playing ass nigga, man.
That nigga gotta go.
This nigga, man. Shut the fuck up, man.
They got this one homeboy they all be treating like shit every day. They be yelling at him when he trying to celebrate and shit. It's very similar to Belly, actually. A lot of things here are similar to Belly. This movie a fake Belly.
This nigga stay running his fucking mouth.
You talk too fucking much, man.
Roll up, man. Do your fucking job. Roll the fuck up.
Nigga, fuck you, man. I ain't doing shit, man. I'm tired of shit.
Oh. The fuck out of here.
You just said fuck you. Look at
you. You ain't just say that, did you, E? Huh? Huh? What the fuck you say? I think it's funny, right? What the fuck you just say? Where you roll up with, matter of fact? Where you roll up with? Put your shit right there. Didn't I tell you?
No, Beans.
Didn't I tell you to roll up, E? Didn't I tell you to roll up?
No, Beans. No, Beans.
Get down. They roll up on the next drug.
That's crazy. Hey, you don't want no friends like that, bruh. If your friends treating you like shit, right? If your friends treating you like shit, bruh, you don't want no friends like that, bruh. At all. You don't want no friends that's bullying you. You don't want no friends that can talk behind your back. You don't want no friends. Like, if you treat your friends with the utmost love and the utmost respect and the utmost care, and it's not being reciprocated, bruh, get away from them people, bruh. Because these are the type of people that will backdoor you. And you'll be like, damn, like, I'm really one of them ones that'll, you know what I mean, be standing right next to you. You need anything, but get away from people that don't mean you no good, bruh.
Drug dealer, then they shoot him and kill him. At this crowded basketball game, that's what I'm talking about with this nigga. That's fucking so OD. I hope these niggas go to jail, bro.
Crowded basketball player, fucking game.
Something happens with Beanie Siegel Plug, and now he gotta wait a week for his drugs. He hate waiting a week for his drugs though, so he decided to go talk to the big boss directly. He taking initiative, he a good businessman. He killing people.
Don't be bullshitting when we get the fuck out there, neither.
Whatever, nigga. Who the fuck the right hand, nigga?
Fuck out of nigga.
Don't take my motherfucking glizzy.
50 Cent is hitting the road. The final lap tour 2023. Celebrating Get Rich or...
Welcome, gentlemen.
Yo, what up?
What are you drinking?
A couple shots of cognac.
Benito, I got key.
Nah, Benito, whatever you said, we don't want no fucking drinks.
For all we know, they have a fucking 1,000 Guala Gualas running through this motherfucker. Kill us and take the fucking money.
Beanie Siegel and Baby Boy meet the Plug, this little weird Spanish teenager. It goes great, too. The whole deal goes great, even though Beanie Siegel's being an asshole the whole time.
Come on, talk English, man. Stuff, man.
Then they get back to Philly. Memphis Bleek is upset about money or something in the movie and probably real life too. Honestly, all these Rockefeller niggas, they just gone from the world. They all Rockefeller off. Where are these niggas?
Beans the one making all that real fucking money, man. We the soldiers putting in the real fucking work. We the killers niggas in the street is scared of.
Didn't you just buy a new car? What the fuck you talking about? Beans getting all the money. Bought you from a have not nigga to a have got nigga.
Yeah, but we could, man. Fuck all that shit. Trust me. That nigga hating on you hard, saying you the only nigga getting money. He gonna try to hook up with your connect and start his own shit.
What? Yo, keep a close eye on that motherfucker, too. Sneaky ass nigga. I got something for him.
Beanie Siegel comes up with a plan to kill the next drug dealer. They get some girl to set the nigga up or something. Pretty standard stuff. Also, Beanie Siegel has a plan for Memphis Bleek too, since he was plotting on him.
See, the more money you make, the more problems you make. If you gotta ride outside the city limits 2 miles to use the payphone, that's what you gotta do.
18th Precinct, may I help you? Yo, look, hurry up, man. I ain't got a whole lot of time, man. Hurry up.
Boy, don't be rushing me. I'm about to treat you.
Precinct?
Do something real nice, huh?
Yo, Bing says suck on this, nigga.
Traffic, traffic! Cap your ass! And your ass! You want some too?
You got him, Cenk!
Oh, shit.
Okay, cool.
Man, this nigga called the police! Oh, hell no!
Correct me if I'm wrong here. Did Beanie Siegel just call the cops on this nigga? Am I tripping or something? That's not gangster at all. Why would they make him do that? I must be tripping.
18th Precinct, may I help you?
Because it was a lot of fucking hard work out there in them streets. I mean, don't get me wrong. Y'all my motherfucking winning team right now. But don't get it twisted for a motherfucking second. Now, y'all see this shit right here? These motherfucking rings? These is for my top dogs right here. When y'all put that shit on, that shit mean for life.
They all get gang rings now, and that's pretty lame and stupid. But hey, they're gangsters though, so you can't tell them that or they're gonna beat you up.
No, B.
Beanie Siegel getting stronger because he got his Rockaware gang member rings. He gotta defeat the next drug dealer now, and this one's super strong. He like a boss fight kinda. Also, Beanie Siegel really, really hate these niggas for some reason. He start narrating and roasting the fuck out of them immediately while he's narrating. It's really uncalled for.
These old ass niggas right here call themselves drug dealers. I mean, look at they squad. Weirdos, they slop. Look at these cats, joking, laughing. Like life's a joke, life's funny. Yeah, right. They don't have a clue what's about to happen.
Like, bro, they just laughing. Give them a break. This nigga too gangster to laugh occasionally? How's he even seeing this shit right now? He's not really here. Like, how do you even know what they're doing right now? I thought he's just supposed to narrate his parts and shit.
Nigga, stay running this fucking mouth.
You talk too fucking much.
Anyway, Dame Dash is in the movie, as you can see. He's the high-level drug dealer, and he loves Rockaware also. Both the gangs wear Rockaware exclusively. This is actually my favorite character in the whole movie. He's kind of funny. He's like the only motherfucker with an actual personality now that I think about it. Everybody else is just random killers. They made everybody else too gangster and forgot to give them personalities. That's hilarious.
Understand me, I don't even know you, man. I mean, I don't even know y'all niggas exist. Y'all niggas call us a beef. All you doing is making yourself hot. You're not affecting me, nigga. I got cake. You making me sick. Actually, I'm laughing at you. We all laughing at you. If it's gonna happen, it's gonna happen. All right?
Beanie Siegel then calls this one nigga named Caesar. He owned a car detail spot and he sell drugs out of it, I'm guessing. He a drug dealer. Beanie Siegel wanna take it over. You know what happens next. It's fine. Go ahead, shoot him, Beanie Siegel.
Yeah, you either gonna get down or you gonna fucking lay down.
Same, man, calm down.
Now what you gonna do, man?
That shit up. What the fuck you doing, man?
Fuck you.
Fucking answer you, yeah.
Yo, it's Dane.
Yo, what's up, Dane?
I gotta talk to you about something. I'm gonna come over here for a little while.
One.
Stop playing.
I got a gun.
That's too DMX. What are you doing?
The Blackening.
All right, man. I'm gonna get back at you. Just give me a minute.
Can't save our ass, nigga.
Yeah, well, watch. Lock the door, man.
Yeah, all right, nigga.
If you find some ass or something, you wouldn't be so fucking violent.
Dame Dash and his friends deep as shit in the club in this young ass booth. I thought these niggas was getting money, bro. Are you kidding me?
It ain't no
trip, man.
Bullshit.
Hey, yo, I know that's not being this
bitch out here like everything is peaches. Here, watch this. Hey, Ma, come here.
Oh, no, we didn't order this. This is courtesy of the gentleman over there.
Okay. Come on. Let's go over there. Come on. Let's go. You wanna go?
No, I can't go over there.
Well, y'all is acting real chicken. I'm out of here.
Thanks for the champagne.
Oh, it's all good. Come sit next to me. Come on.
actually sent the champagne to your homegirl, man. Why she acting like that? A little antisocial? She got a cold?
But she got a man and he be bugging.
Who's that man?
Beans. And if he come up in here, it's gonna be trouble.
Fuck me. Hold on, hold on. Tell your girl she must get a real man, you know, come fuck with me.
What?
Jay-Z tells Dame Dash that he should kidnap Beanie Siegel's girlfriend. That's not cool, Jay-Z. Why you say that? This is pretty much it for Jay-Z, by the way. He don't do shit else. He's not really in the movie at all. This nigga filmed all his scenes in one day, I'm sure.
Yo, what's up?
Wake up, nigga. Got your bitch.
Fuck is this? You wanna see your bitch, man? Act like you know.
What bitch?
This bitch. Nigga.
I figure she's worth about 500,000, about 50 of them things, pause.
You gonna get your money, all right? Cause you gonna need that shit to bury your fucking mother.
Shit. Just to let you know I'm serious.
Hey, Bob, shoot that bitch.
Beanie Siegel pays the ransom and he gets his girl back. She happy now. After that, we go back to Caesar. Remember Caesar from the car shit? He actually survived and now the police want to know what happened.
Man, look at this fucking bitch ass nigga right here. Hustler's number one rule. You never snitch.
Wait a minute, bruh. Didn't you just snitch on Miss Bleak? Didn't you just backdoor Mrs. Bleak?
Ever. Not even on your worst enemy. You never, ever snitch. But as you can see, that's a rule that's rarely followed.
You know, I like how this nigga was casually murdering hella people. Now he trying to blame somebody else for getting caught. You were not careful at all, sir. You can't just shoot everybody. You also called the cops on your own homeboy. What the fuck was that? That never gets resolved.
Yo, I'll be right back. I gotta go do something real quick. What's wrong with you? What is it, that Tanya situation about the kidnap? Look, I told you I was gonna handle that shit.
I want your daughter to have a dad. You know you go to court, I mean, what is you thinking about?
What's wrong with you, man?
This nigga said, you still mad over the kidnapping. Yes, she probably is. You sound crazy right now. Who wrote this shit, bro? I feel like niggas wrote this shit in a jail cell. Also, listen to this weak-ass soap opera music. This just sound like Minecraft music.
Don't worry about it. You gonna be all right.
That's probably
just Blaze me. It's a bad idea, man. I don't think we should be out in the open like this already, man. It's still hot and everything. You know what I'm saying? I'm just saying, man. We gotta be smart. You know what I'm saying?
What's wrong now? You nervous? Nah, man.
Bro, how is his acting still so bad and he's not even saying shit right now? This nigga doing like some fucking WWE acting. Then Dame Dash comes into the club. This fucking same ass club they've been reusing since the beginning of the movie. They did like 5 scenes here. Beanie Siegel then goes to meet up with his lawyers to talk about shooting Caesar.
They say Caesar's going to testify against you for attempted murder.
I really think it's a bluff.
Man, bluff my dick.
This case is too high profile. It's been on TV and all the newspapers, shootouts in public places, bodies turning up all over the city.
Fuck, man. Look, I got a fucking family. A daughter to take care of.
Oh no, you better fucking stop it, movie. Don't try to be relatable now, motherfucker. Are you kidding me? This nigga is so unlikable. Like, why would I ever be rooting for him? He complained about his life at the beginning of the movie a little bit, and I'm supposed to care about him? The first thing we really see him do is beat an old man to death with a bat. They should have gave this nigga at least one good quality to balance him out. This nigga a psychopath. This nigga shooting up basketball games. World. That's not related.
Hey, no, that's what he is. He's a fucking psychopath.
Jay-Z pops up again and he puts a call in to his assassin lady. This is the assassin lady right here. She a rapper too. I never heard of most of these fucking rappers actually. I'm only pointing them out for you guys. Also, I'm sure I probably missed a bunch of them too. I'm sorry. Anyway, Jay-Z is putting a hit out on Beanie.
Nah, they definitely was popping back in the day.
Siegel. At least I think he is. He's using this fucking hilarious made-up secret language.
Yeah, no. Use what your meals like that go with his name. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, you know I got you.
You know his name, right?
Yeah.
It's time for the trial now. Beanie Siegel ends up paying Caesar like $1 million or something to keep him quiet. He looks like he's gonna do it. But just to be sure, Beanie Siegel friends come into the courthouse and kill him anyway. These niggas shooting up the courthouse now? That's fucking top tier savage shit. What the fuck? These niggas crazy.
I knew I'd be rotting a bench one day, but not like this. In front of my daughter? I mean, what the fuck was baby boy and D-Nice thinking? But that shit was gangster though, right? Keep it real, I went out like a gangster.
Bro, what a piece of shit. He's not even concerned about what his family went through. Your girl got kidnapped. Your daughter just saw hella people die in front of her. This nigga laughing, joking, like life's a joke, like life's funny.
These old ass niggas. Bullshit. That shit only happened in the fucking movies. I got quadruple life. I'm state property. They gonna remember my name. They gonna remember Beans.
Okay, wait, I'm confused. That shit didn't happen then? So what happened? He had a regular ass trial and he was just daydreaming? What about the hitman lady? Did that really happen? Did he really call her? So I guess he's not dead though. I guess he in jail. I don't feel bad for him. This is exactly what jail is made for, actually. Get this nigga the fuck out of here, man.
Stinky black bat.
This isn't the worst movie I've ever seen, but it's definitely some amateur shit, and it's got a lot of flaws. None of the characters were really interesting. None of his homeboys were interesting. The filmmakers were so focused on the gangster shit part that they forgot to do shit else. They tried to show Beanie Siegel at this birthday party and shit for like 5 seconds so they could try to say he's a family man. He's not a family man. This nigga insane, bro. He's a poorly written character. Like, it's fine if you want to have your main pin drug dealers.
All right, talking too much. Hey, see y'all niggas in the next video, though.